Hey guys, Jeff off the Gridiron. Well, we're here at the shelter, and we're just going to walk in now, get set up. We've got some bushcraft activities to do, and brought the boys along today, so they're going to explore some twig stove cooking, making some lunch. Each of them have a saw. We're going to get right at it, make some camp crafts. Why don't you join us? Let's go. Hey guys, thanks for joining me. We're heading back to the shelter. We haven't been back since the snow's disappeared, so I brought the boys out today, so we're gonna get at some camp crafts and check out the shelter, see how it weathered the winter. And then the boys are gonna make their own lunch today in the twig stove. So we brought a twig stove, and we'll showcase that for you and see if they can figure out how to put it together. Boil some water for their lunch.
This is where the super shelter was.
What's the super shelter?
Well, the super shelter is where you have a big fire in front of the shelter made of the plastic, and it traps the heat inside the plastic. And then it keeps you warm at night. So that's where that was. So we're going to get it out of the way. This is our big mattress cover. This is a big king size mattress cover from one of the furniture companies. And this is what I used earlier this winter for my super shelter. It already has three sealed sides on it, as you can see. So what I did, I punched a hole in one of the corners, ran a ridge line out through the open end of the mattress bag cover. And then I was able to just make a few little clothespins to close that end in. That was my head end of the shelter, and it worked really well. So I left this in the tree just in the event that I'd come back to it. Now that I'm not going to be using it right now, I'm going to pack it up. Okay guys, me and the boys are out at the shelter, and we took off the tarp, and we're now laying in more branches. If we can close it up for the most part, any of the kind of leaf litter and deadfall that land on top will eventually create that roof structure for us and close it in. Inevitably, if we come back out, we'll throw the tarp over it to keep it a little more rainproof. But right now, we're just finding straight logs, laying it on the top, and increasing the horizontal pieces just for support. And we're going to get little pieces and start closing in the sides, and that should be a good makings to
Okay, we're just about ready for lunch, or getting ready to start a lunch. The boys wanted to do a twig stove, so I brought my twig stove kit. And I'm just going to hand it over to them and provide them some guidance and see if they can get some water boiled, certainly get the stove put together, and get some water on for their noodles. Here you go, guys. Let's see if you can make lunch. It's the Make Lunch Bushcraft Challenge.
There, but
you're
going to have to
take it out of there and assemble everything.
I thought this was the pot that we were cooking in.
Well, that's the pot that's going to boil the water.
Yeah.
How does this come out?
Careful, it should lift out of there. Just lift out of there.
This handle's got to come off. You got to take the handle off. There you go. Now the whole kit should lift out of there. Grab the black handle, the black kit. Clean that out first. You gotta clean that out first. That's what you're gonna eat out of. Dust it out first. It's already clean. You just have to dust it out. That's a waste of drinking water. I'll just dust. Okay. So we're not ready for the water yet. Are you gonna put water in now?
Yeah.
Okay.
But first I need to start the fire.
No, we gotta get everything ready first. So Keaton and Landon are going to try to get our twig stove kit put back together and assembled. Okay. Just set that off to the side. Oh, you're gonna use the gantry hook. Okay. So Landon, let's see if you can get that stove put together. You gotta build a stove out of that kit there.
A stove?
Yeah, in that black kit is a stove. Take all the parts out and see if you can figure out how to put it together. Those are all my extra pieces. You're good at puzzles, we'll see. That's just a pot, so that goes off to the side. They should slide apart. The other part slides apart. Yeah. Open that up. There you go. Let's see if you can stack them up and figure out how they go together. Does it push it? Does it push through the other way? Maybe it doesn't go. Maybe that piece is solid. And the rings go to the bottom. You're getting pretty close. You're getting pretty close. Check the writing on the side of the can. That'll tell you which side is which words go up. Well, we're not going to use the grate because we're not cooking anything. Right? There you go. And that's just an extra thing for fuel. Okay, now we'll get our twigs. Well, we're not going to start it on top of the bench, but we're going to move it. Okay, let's load it full of twigs. Use the back side of your blade. Is it not sharp enough?
No.
Turn your knife 90 degrees. Point it down at the jelly.
Yeah, right there.
That's it. There you go. Pick it up, put it in. That's it. Okay, little twigs.
We don't need leaves. It's already going, Landon. And you use the next size. Get those little twigs. Okay, before we lose our lighting stuff, let's pick that up out of the way. Where did they all go? Get the saw blade out of there. Okay, you can add little twigs to the front of the stove. No use washing your hands. We're not eating. That water's going to take about 20 minutes to boil, maybe, maybe not. Just have to keep adding twigs. Okay, water's boiling on the Lixada twig stove. We've got our large pot on there, and we just supported it off the swing arm just in the event that it tipped over. It's a little top heavy. So it's roll and boil now. We're going to pull it off and add it to our noodles. Grab the top thing, okay? Some water, Landon. There's your noodles. Get your noodles ready. So we have some soup that we had in the freezer. Freeze-dried soup. Not freeze-dried, I guess dehydrated soup mix, right? Mm-hmm. Pour that in here. Like that. Pour that. This is spicy for sure. And I brought two of them. I have no idea what they are, but. Lid on and let that rehydrate. Well, as a cleanup from lunch, boys have already left off to play. And it's important that you, when you take your kids and family outdoors, that you teach them how to use these skills. Today we had a good practice with flint and steel and learning that it's not as easy as one might think. I also, before I leave, make sure I keep some extra kindling, in this case ziplocked up. I'll leave this stashed for later. Oh, you got some water? How was it? Not bad?
Scary.
I almost fell in. That's good. Well, what do you think we should do? We should dump this out first. This is still hot. We're just emptying our Lixada stove. I think many of these stoves you can buy on different discount sites. This is a Lixada. We got this one from somebody else, but it came originally from Amazon, I think. And I'm super happy with it. It burns great. So why are we putting all the water on here?
So we don't want it to be hot anymore.
Yeah. Make sure we douse all our coals and make a soup out of it. Then we can put our finger in it and make sure there's no hot spots. Sure. Oh, that's still hot, eh? So that's washed off. That's washed off.
See if it's hot in there? No?
It's all cooled down to the touch. Super. Picked up this today. I didn't, or the other day, I wasn't going to use it today because I didn't really want to, but it's just a expandable bowl from the dollar store. That's pretty handy. And all right, so it let's try to get this packed back up, Keaton, and then we'll wash it later. Leftover chunk of ice from there we go.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, go ahead. Put it down inside it. Put the garbage around here and then we'll go for a hike. Oh, I know what we had in here. We had a little can of canned heat, magic flame, up to 1 hour. But usually I just use a dollop of this on whatever kind of semi-dry kindling, and that lights right up. Got an extra kind of broken fire steel. I use that one right in half, and with a magnesium block. Again, another fire source. And I think what I'll do for good measure for next time is just throw a lighter in here as well. There's my entire kit, and I think that's it. There's the lid, and we'll tuck it in this mesh bag. Okay, and are we done with the water? Does anybody need to fill the water? I guess. Take the bale off because it won't get past the bale. That sits down in like so. And again, I put this extra bale on here. This was an old coiled wire off a clamp light. But I put a piece of cork through there, and that never gets warm. It's always you're able to hang on to it. So from there in the handle, you can always use it like that, and if the handle's too hot, you still have that cool surface, and then you can tip it up or use a stick to dump your pot. What else goes in here? Soap in the bucket. You know what, Keaton? I think because this is collapsible, I think that'll fit right in there like so. And then the soap, and then our lid. And there is our whole kind of, I guess multi-person, eh, Keaton?
Mm-hmm.
Multi-purpose kit. And I'm going to take some of the leaf litter. And get off some of that charring off the side of the pot. I don't get the inside of my bag all covered in black. There we go. So that's our kit. And in fact, you know what? This rope was so handy today, I think I might just wrap it up and leave it all together like that for next time. All right, lunch is done. We're gonna pick up the garbage and go for a hike. Gnarly grapevine tree. Grapevine. Hey, buddy.
Smile.
See his claws?
Yeah. He's like.
Let's
go find one.
chunk of old cedar. That would make a great little table there. So we're going to pull it up to the camp and see if we can make a table out of it. Pieces of my my kit that I'm starting to carry now is one of these little auger bit, and this is a tap and die kind of setup. And because that that end is designed for a drill or a brace, it does fit neatly into the die. This nice portable setup, much like a scotch auger. Now I'm going to use this to create my peg holes. So we want two posts or legs coming off here at the same angle as I'm starting this drill. So you have to push down at the same time. Well, it's just to put stuff on, right? Okay. I might split this side off here. Okay, that's good.
Well, guys, thanks for joining me and the boys today. We had a great day at the shelter. Worked on some campcraft projects. We made that little table. The boys cooked some lunch on the twig stove, which was always a novel experience for them. And now we're just heading back to the truck.
Okay, I'll be right there.
Don't forget to click like and subscribe, and leave comments down below if you have any questions about what you saw today. That's all from This End of Things. Take care. Enjoy your outdoors. Bye for now.